Let me try and give you an example. That's, I think, why jokes work. If you think about it, the interconnected nature of the brain indicates, doesn't it, that something in there to do with connection is happening. Sorry about that plug. Okay. Now, if what your brain is supposed to do best is make new connections, then that's why you like jokes, because the punchline connects two things you didn't know were connected, and you laugh because your network has just been enriched. Okay, let me try it. Everybody in this room has in their model here the concept bird and the concept fruit. And like everything in the brain, it is linked in some way. Your link may be bird, tree, fruit, bird, eat fruit, bird, color, fruit, I don't know. See if I can put a new one in there. If I do, you'll laugh. A drunk goes up to his host at a party and says, with all that seriousness of the totally plastered adult, "Excuse me." And the host turns around and says, "Yes." And there's a drunk swaying, glazed-eyed, you know. And the host says, "Yes, what's the problem?" And the drunk says, "There's no problem. I just wondered if you could tell me, do lemons whistle?" And the host says, "No, they don't whistle. Why do you ask?" And the drunk staggers back and smacks his forehead in chagrin and says, "Oh, my God, in that case, I have just squeezed your canary into my gin and tonic."
You get a little fella at a party, a cocktail party, goes up to the hostess and says, "Excuse me, madam, but do lemons have feathers?" She said, "I beg your pardon, do lemons have feathers?" She said, "I don't think so. Why?" He said, "Well, in that case, I've just squeezed your canary into my drink."